Coming up on the Met Report.
Being paralyzed doesn't stop one MSU Denver student from pursuing his dreams.
College students in Paris play their part in the recovery following the terrorist attacks.
Everyone's just kind of supporting each other.
More snow in our forecast? Find out how it'll affect your travel plans. The Met Report starts now.
Welcome to this week's edition of The Met Report. I'm Anthony Rodriguez.
And I'm Miranda McCotchkins. The spring semester is right around the corner, which means startup week is closer than you think. Tomas Lopez gives us some tips to help ease your financial aid experience.
We've all been there before. Startup week at the Office of Financial Aid can be crazy.
My name is Brittany Wood, and I am a peer counselor in the Office of Financial Aid. The first thing is always check your email. That's the only official communication that we will contact any student. It's important for students to ask questions and make sure you're not afraid of asking those questions, because it is our job to help you. Most of the positions here are called advisors, because we are literally giving you all of the advice on how to get financial aid.
Many students find themselves making multiple trips to and from the Office of Financial Aid, not knowing that these few tips will save them both time and stress.
Some things that students need to realize is that the Office of Financial Aid is literally the middleman between the government and the student. We physically do not have any money. We just use the FAFSA to determine what money the student qualifies for and to request that money from the government. Another good important thing is to make sure that you always do your FAFSA early on. It's always available January 1st of every year, and as soon as you get that done, it comes into our office about 2 to 3 weeks later. Office of Financial Aid is located in the Student Success Building off of 890 Aurelio Parkway. We're office number 6, and our office hours are Monday through Thursday, 8 to 5:30.
With the Met Report, Tomas Lopez.
Governor John Hickenlooper has revealed the new budget plan for 2016, which could result in increase in tuition. The budget is proposing a $20 million reduction from what is currently allocated for higher education. This translates to an average increase of 8.7% for tuition statewide. Colleges and universities are expected to generate $76 million from tuition and student fees.
The Student Government Association is hosting a Thanksgiving basket drive for the MSU Denver Food Bank. Students can help by donating non-perishables at the SGA office in Tivoli 307. The food bank is open for eligible students. For more information or to register, visit the Dean of Students page on msudenver.edu or visit them in person inside Ziggy's Pool Hall.
Being paralyzed may limit what someone can do, but one MSU Denver student isn't letting his condition get in the way of his dreams.
Julian is a guy, a regular guy, with a brain that works just fine. And a body that doesn't.
This is my semester at Vessel.
When Julian was 8 months old, he developed a rare form of spinal muscular atrophy, paralyzing him. He requires 24-hour care with the help of a feeding tube and ventilator. His nurse Robert travels with Julian and tends to his medical needs. Robert gives him massages to keep his body moving. Because he's unable to swallow, he uses a vacuum to clear his throat. Julian is in the individual degree program at MSU.
Well, most of these are presentations to society by music or sports. That's something that I love to do.
I think seeing Julian get excited and change and progress and make his life better on his own is what thrills me every day. And it's what makes me want to come to work.
After meeting a guy like Julian, you'll get to learn his crass sense of humor pretty quickly.
Crass as it may be, it is his sense of humor.
It's a little bit twisted.
A little twisted, that's right, Julian.
For the Met Report, Belen Ward.
With the threat of terror activity on the rise, aerospace professionals have to adapt security protocols to prepare for new security threats. Professor Jeffrey Price says the aerospace program at MSU Denver keeps a close relationship with the industry to bring the latest industry updates to the classroom. Price is the co-author of the Aviation Security textbook, Practical Aviation, which he says has become an industry standard across the country.
It's evolution. Just as the terrorist organizations and the criminals will evolve to evade the existing security protections, the law enforcement, TSA, FBI, military, we have to evolve with that.
With a spike in campus crime across the country, the Auraria Police Department is adding new technology to help students feel secure on campus.
The organization Texas Tip 2 came to campus and is located in the administration building. The Auraria campus is the first program to do it with no cost.
We've seen great results. It's been very, very useful for us. So from the first day we told people that we had it, people started using it, and we probably get at least one Texas Tip a day, maybe more. And many of them have resulted in us interrupting criminal activity.
With such results, the Met Report went around asking students about their thoughts on Texas Tip 2.
I think it's convenient, you know, it's like you never know the situation. Like, you know, if there's an attacker in the room or something, and the last thing you want to do is be talking on the phone.
Texas Tip doesn't only accept text messages, but pictures are welcome too.
We've had people text us and report suspicious activity in restrooms where people were shooting up heroin. And so we've interrupted that at least half a dozen times. We've had people report suspicious things going on at the light rail stations. One of the first cases we had was a stalking case where the victim of the stalking and her friend were able to use Texas Tip. They were even able to send us a photograph of the person. So we used that photograph and the location it was taken from to jump on the cameras that we have here on campus, go back and look at the recordings. We were able to see the person. And then we could follow them backwards, all the way back to a cash register purchase they made with a credit card. We learned their name and were in contact with them shortly thereafter the next morning.
For the Met Report, Andrea Herrera.
Well, Miranda, you heard the students there. That Texas Tip is incredibly useful and convenient.
Yeah, I agree. I think it's a great platform for students to use to let the police know when they're not feeling safe.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, it's been a little chilly here in the Mile High. Here's our Josh Kozart to let us know if that trend will continue.
Actually, we're seeing our warmest temperatures of the day right now with a high of 44 degrees. Partly sunny skies out there for us, but the wind is going to be the biggest story today, and it's going to last into the evening hours. 43 degrees by the 1 o'clock period, and then the cold front swings through, and that's going to drop our temperatures down to 25 degrees by the 9 o'clock period. And I would not be surprised if we saw some snow flurries right around the 3 o'clock period or so. Some places might even see up to an inch of snow with this upcoming system. For our averages, our high temperature usually about 50 degrees, low 22, so we're a little under that this week, but we have been relatively warm over the past few months. 8.7 inches is our average snow amounts that we see for the month of November. And then we do have a winter weather advisory for most of the high country this afternoon, and it's going to be expiring right around the 6 o'clock period. Right in the Indian Peaks region, we will see 4 to 12 inches of snow as you take a route on I-70, 8 to 14 inches up there. So if you are traveling up in the mountains, make sure that you are prepared for the snow. I'll have all my detailed forecasts coming up in just a few minutes.
Thanks, Josh. Coming up, participating in the Color Run may put your health at risk.
Another retailer decides to keep their doors closed on Black Friday.
And in sports, women's volleyball seek revenge against the team they had lost to twice this season. Our MAC tournament highlights you don't want to miss. We'll be right back.
Welcome back. Students in Paris came back from their fall break to a school in mourning. Janice Cadascale has more.
From the French Congress to the memorials scattered across Paris, the City of Light mourns its victims from last week's Islamic State attacks.
Aux armes, citoyens!
Many victims were young people, and universities are coping with the loss.
It seems everywhere that you go and everyone you talk to, they either lost someone or they knew someone that was injured.
Schools are raising their security measurements and supporting students who need to talk.
They started searching everyone's backpacks. There were also professional psychologists at the school waiting.
The attackers were also young. She says she thinks the attackers are just lost kids.
they're told, you know, we're going to feed you, we're going to protect you. And then eventually they're obliged to be a part of this. Unfortunately, sometimes brainwashed as well.
She says, like all Parisians, they are recovering their own way.
Everyone's just kind of supporting each other. We're just trying to comfort everyone. Everyone's open and not shutting themselves out.
They are healing with art, food, and love.
People are still going out. They're still trying to live their normal life, and they're not letting Paris become some place where everyone's afraid to go out.
For the Met Report, Janice Carrasquel.
Tax increases on feminine products in the UK have sparked protests from women across the country. Two women protested outside of Parliament wearing stained white pants, making pedestrians uncomfortable. Tax on the product stands at 17.5%. Protesters want the products to be tax-free.
Mislabeling on birth control pills has resulted in several pregnancies in one big lawsuit. More than 100 women have filed suit against Qualitas Pharmaceuticals after they packaged and sold birth control pills with a label oriented 180 degrees the wrong way. This caused women to take the placebo pill instead of the proper active pill, causing at least 94 pregnancies.
November is National Adoption Month, and this year the focus goes to foster care. According to the Adoption and Foster Care Analysis and Reporting System, over 420,000 children are in the foster care system in the U.S., with nearly 115,000 children available for adoption. According to the research, 40% of American adults have considered adoption. MSU Denver helps these foster kids in areas of life.
Less than a third of all foster kids will attempt college, and only 2% will end up with a bachelor's degree. So we try to provide that support, whether it's food, access to money, housing, anything we can do that will make their life easier.
Black Friday is generally one of the largest retail days of the year, which is why it was quite a shock when the retailer REI announced that they will not open for Black Friday this year. The outdoor retailer has launched a campaign to convince people to go spend time outside this Black Friday instead of rushing to the stores. In addition, REI has announced that they will not be processing any online orders on Black Friday. REI joins a list of other retail giants pledging to stay closed on Thanksgiving.
The Westinette DIA opened its doors for the first time yesterday. The sleek designed hotel that resembles open wings offers over 500 rooms, two restaurants, a spa, and a transit terminal. The commuter rail will pass through the hotel starting spring 2016. In addition, it is the first hotel to be built directly attached to the airport.
The happiest 5K on the planet has ignited in popularity in recent years. The infamous Color Run is a 5K that has made visits in cities across the country. At the end of the race, participants are doused in various colored powders. But experts are concerned that the powder may not only be toxic to participants' lungs, but also highly flammable. Despite this, organizers claim the powder is made from food-grade cornstarch and is 100% safe.
Tonight's going to be a really chilly one, so if you're heading out, be sure to grab the heavy coat, the gloves, the scarves. You're going to need it, especially after the midnight hours, because clouds are going to start to clear out and our temperature is going to drop down to about 13 degrees, and we're going to have calm winds as well, so that's really going to make things really chilly out there. So for tomorrow, when you wake up right around the 9 o'clock period, if you get the chance to sleep in, 22 degrees will be your high, plenty of sunshine, and that sunshine is going to continue into the afternoon hours, and we'll get up to a high of about 41 degrees, and the winds are going to be a lot calmer tomorrow than they are today. Now taking a look at Sunday, 53, so we really start to warm up as high pressure system starts to move in, which I'll get into a little bit more here in just a moment, and the sunshine is going to continue, and we will see light winds for your Sunday. Taking a look at the metro area, Denver at 42 degrees, Aurora and Parker both at 41, and as you head up to the high country into the mid 40s. Sunday temperatures, again, all across the metro area, we are going to warm up. Denver at 53, Thornton at 54. Down in the southern areas, you guys are going to be a little bit chillier because of all that snow that's still on the ground than rest of the metro area. We do have this high pressure system sitting over Colorado. That's creating a clockwise rotation or an anticyclonic rotation. That's what's going to start to kind of fire up those snow showers up in the high country. Then we also have this low pressure system turning over the St. Louis area. So if you're traveling out there for Thanksgiving, you are going to see a little bit of snow in the Chicago, Des Moines area, and Memphis, you will see some rain as well for your Saturday. Sunday, though, that high pressure system really intensifies. It shifts down to the south. That cold pressure, cold front moves its way out of here, and that the high pressure system's going to bring in a lot of cold air for us for our weekend. Monday, though, for the Denver metro area, a nice 56 degrees. Tuesday at 57, and the sunshine continues all the way to Wednesday. And then Thursday, Thanksgiving, a chilly 35 degrees and a low of 9. Friday's low is looking pretty chilly as well, with a chance for some snow. Speaking of snow, down south we saw quite a bit. This is actually from our director, Douglas Coulter. He had to bury himself out to get here today, and really all across the metro area south of the Denver area saw a lot of snow this past week, and some of us up north didn't quite see as much. But if you do have an amazing photo you'd like to share, send it via Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. We would absolutely love to see and share those photos. Guys, I only saw about an inch at my house. I live up north, but down south, boy, they were hammered.
Well, as you noted, there's been such a huge difference in snowfall. Why has it been that difference?
Really, the difference is because the Palmer Divide's just south of Denver, and the upslope event was more to the south than it was to the Rocky Mountains.
Interesting. Gotcha. All right, well, coming up next, EMET. Now joining us for EMET is Melanie Townsend.
Hey guys, happy Friday. And as always, it's my pleasure to bring you up to speed with what is happening in the world of entertainment news. And what better way to recap than with EMET's Top 5.
At number 5 for your concert watch in Denver, who's ready to rock? The Trans-Siberian Orchestra is playing at the Pepsi Center tomorrow, and tickets are going fast. At number 4, the 21st season of Dancing with the Stars is nearing the end as the contestants compete for the Mirrorball Trophy on ABC's finale. Nick Carter, Bindi Irwin, Carlos Pena-Vega, and Alex Scarlatos are through to the final round. Tamar Braxton unfortunately left the competition early due to a case of pneumonia. The dance must go on without her. At number 3, Ronda Rousey may have painfully lost the UFC 193 fight against kickboxing champ Holly Holmes, but the battle against social media backlash still rages on. People have called Rousey out, saying that's what she gets for not bumping gloves and being humble. Yet, she still gathers support from friends such as Floyd Mayweather, who said, quote, "I don't think it's cool how everyone is trolling her on social media. I'm pretty sure she's a very, very strong person, but we still have to take into consideration that she has feelings." At number 2, a shocking confession from the Warlock himself. In an interview with Today's Show, Matt Lauer, Charlie Sheen reveals he has been HIV positive for the last 4 years and spent $10 million to keep his condition out of the public eye. And finally, at number 1 for our viral vid, let me just bless your ears with some Adele greatness for just a second. The superbly soulful British singer's new hit single, Hello, has become a chart topper with over 400 million hits on YouTube alone. The song has already been turned into hilarious parodies and covered by other artists such as Demi Lovato.
Okay, Adele, we get it. You're amazing, and your voice sounds like a combination of Fergie and Jesus. But give me a song that doesn't pluck at my heartstrings so much, okay? Well, besides sobbing on your couch and listening to Adele songs this weekend, here's what else you could do. I'll give you a few hints. 1, it's local. 2, it's educational. And 3, it's at the Denver Museum of Nature and Science.
Explore the mystery and intrigue on Baker Street at the International Exhibition of Sherlock Holmes.
And as the great detective says, you should never formulate theories until you have all the facts.
Guests can discover the inspiration behind this iconic detective, see his life of luxury, get a glimpse at some cool Holmes memorabilia, and play actual detectives themselves using clues and codes to unravel a crime in true Sherlock fashion.
Sherlock has such an amazing story to it where you can really dive into sleuthing out this mystery for yourself. And use those techniques that Sherlock uses so masterfully as you kind of follow along this wonderful storyline.
Never guess, it's a terribly bad habit, of course.
Often the smallest or prettiest specimen is the deadliest. And that's what you'll discover in the all-new Power of Poison exhibit.
And this is a wonderful place to work. This museum is extraordinary because you come in here and it's like going into a different land. Everybody is curious and everybody is helpful and everybody is open to, you know, asking and answering questions, and it's a magnificent place to be.
Both exhibits are here for the holiday season until mid-January, so be sure to check them out.
I'm with Carol. Those exhibits were amazing. And the best part? They were inside where it was nice and warm. Can I get an amen? Well, guys, I did my part. I gave you some ideas as to what to do with your weekend fun, but I know for sure what I'm going to be doing, and that's heading down to my local theater and checking out this exciting new must-see.
I love you too.
Come one, come all, to the final epic installment of The Hunger Games: Mockingjay Part 2. The stakes are higher as Katniss and her valiant Star Squad take the fight to the Capitol and move to bring down the tyrannical President Snow. The new arena is now the Capitol itself, filled with even more dangerous booby traps, creatures, and moral obstacles for the girl on fire to leap through. The game's red carpet premiere in Paris was canceled due to the frightening terrorist attacks last Friday. Jennifer Lawrence shared a heartfelt tweet expressing her condolences to the people of Paris. Despite recent events, audiences look forward to the end of a sensation and all wish the final odds ever in her favor. For this next must-see, this is worth it, watch her work it. She puts her thing down, flips it, and reverses it in an all-new music video. Missy Elliott is back and looking fierce, releasing a new single featuring Pharrell called WTF. And no, not that WTF. It stands for Where They From. Give a listen.
Well, it's good to see both my girls back in action. Thank you for watching EMED, and don't go away, because sports is next.
Now joining us for sports is John Madden.
Now, becoming the champ is something every athlete dreams of. And after failing to make the postseason last year, the Lady Roadrunners basketball team is back at it with their sights set on a national championship. After winning their first exhibition game, they look to get another win under their belt, taking on Grandview in their final preseason tune-up. MSU Denver waxed Northern New Mexico in their previous game, and Grandview was trying to prevent that from happening to them. In the first, Roadrunner fans say hello to Janae Squires Horton, a transfer from Adams State University who can shoot the lights out. Next possession, Hannah Stepanovich gets the feed and gets the and one. Silky smooth. Stepanovich had 13 points on the night. But Grandview kept it close with number 30, Renice Collier, banking in this layup. And then later, her teammate number 24, Maddie Westergaard, fights through traffic and lays it in, cutting the Roadrunners' lead to 6. But this drive attempt by Grandview gets blocked by Georgia Ordor. Bye, Felicia. The Roadrunners would build upon their lead when Janae, I Came to Bring the Pain, hits from downtown. MSU Denver would take a 40-26 lead into the half. And in the second half, Emily Hardigan was on fire. The sophomore forward took over as Grandview had no answer for her. After she hits this drive, she was so hot that her shooting hand was actually on fire. Ouch. Here's her 20th point on the night, as she also had 7 rebounds and 2 steals, which helped lead a well-balanced offensive attack as MSU Denver ethers Grandview 77-47. Coach Javi, mic check.
I thought some in the first half we got outplayed.
a little bit. We got out hustled, and so was a little disappointed in that. So it was like, look, let's play every possession as hard as we can, and we got everybody. Everybody's getting to play, so we've got good balance right there. So it's the message is we are doing well, but we need to do a lot better.
Now, the ladies were not the only ones hitting the court as men's basketball fell to 0-2 on their young season after a 66-76 loss to Arkansas Fort Smith. The Roadrunners' Andre Harris was balling with 13 points and 12 boards, and the Roadrunners had a 32-31 lead at half, but lost that advantage due to their 37% shooting for the game compared to 46% for Arkansas. The road trip continues as the men face Eastern Oregon tonight in the Beaver State. Now, the playoffs is where athletes and teams strive to be. It's where Derek Jeter became Captain Clutch, where Michael Jordan solidified himself as a legend, and it's a place that the Colorado Rockies may never see again. The women's volleyball team hosted UCCS in the RMAC tournament last Tuesday. So the question to ask is, which team would get the Ronda Rousey treatment and get knocked out way too early? MSU Denver was 0-2 against the Cougars this season, including a 3-0 loss last Saturday. But it's tough to beat a good team three times, and Michaela Smith starts things off for the Roadrunners with this kill, putting them up early in the first set. Then, double trouble as Ryan Herdeman and Pasadi Fiatowa go for the kill. So who would get it? Would it be A, Ryan Herdeman, B, Pasadi Fiatowa, or C, The Rock, who doesn't care what you think? The answer would be A, Ryan Herdeman, who had 14 kills on the night. Check out Kristen Anderson on the bottom left corner, who lays out for the dig, which then sets up number 12, Summer Gregor, for the kill. MSU Denver will close out the highly contested first set 26-24. But UCCS came to party too, and with this kill, they would rally to take the second set 25-23. So now the third set. Summer Gregor was back at it. She was schooling cats all night with her 18 kills. Then later, Brandi Tor catches the Cougars off guard. Ha, got him. The Lady Roadrunners would take the third set 25-18. And in the fourth set, Herdeman, bam! She smacks that ball like a bad date, getting the Roadrunners the point. And not to be outdone, Summer Gregor, get some! MSU Denver gets the victory 3-1 and moves on to the second round of the RMAC tourney. Whew! Coach Hendricks, how you feeling?
We were ultimately looking to have a great response to what happened on Saturday night. And I tell you, that team is about as good on defense as any team we've seen this year. They're just relentless and kept bringing the ball back. And Saturday, what happened is our hitters became frustrated and took poor swings. So this, I thought tonight we were more patient, waited for the right opportunities to take aggressive swings.
So the volleyball team will take on Colorado Mesa tonight in the second round of the RMAC tourney. They are 0-2 against Mesa this season, but they were also 0-2 against UCCS, the team they just beat. Yeah.
Do you think they'll advance against Mesa tonight?
Well, momentum is in their favor. They're playing well. I like the chances.
Yeah. I mean, to have the season end in an RMAC championship would be awesome. Yeah.
It'd be great to see the volleyball team pull away with a championship belt just yes. like that one right there. That'd be nice.
Well, thanks, John. And for all the latest campus news and events, be sure to visit our website at mymetmedia.com and connect with us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. We'd love to hear from you.
For the entire Met Report staff, thanks for tuning in to the Met Report. Have a great fall break.